Today, we ray diving into the fascinating world of spiders, and trust me, this one essay show stopper. Ever heard of the Joro spider? What does a Joro spider look like? Extremely long legs. Legs can be 4 times as long as the body. Striped legs, often yellow and black. Bright colors: red, yellow, brown, blue, and black. Usually appear in fall months, September and October. Weave distinct 3-layered, orb-shaped, gold-tinted webs. The adult female Joro spider is large and brilliantly colored with bright yellow and gray-blue bands and patterns on both its upper and lower abdomen. The cephalothorax is covered with silvery and golden hairs, and the legs are black with yellow bands. Maybe the most stunning feature of this spider is its size. Female body length can measure up to 1 inch, with a leg span of up to 4 inches. To put that into perspective, the average size of a human palm is 3 to 3.5 inches. Male Joro spiders are much smaller and less vibrantly colored than the females. Their body length is typically 0.3 inches, and they have more dark brown colors. Joro spider origins, habitats, and U.S. locations. Named after a Japanese spider demon, Joro, Joro spiders hail from Southeast Asia. They are common in China, Japan, Korea, Taiwan, and Vietnam in the early 2010s. The spider arrived in Georgia, likely via shipping containers imported into the United States. Since then, these arachnids have been spotted in various points across the Southeast. While Joro spiders prefer warmth and humidity, they can survive in virtually any weather. Recent research indicates they may be able to survive in much colder temperatures than initially known. Their resistance to the cold could cause them to spread to northern states in the future. Since their discovery in the U.S., the Joro spider has been found in Alabama, Georgia, South Carolina, North Carolina, and Tennessee. There have also been unconfirmed reports of this spider in Maryland, Oklahoma, and West Virginia. Scientists at the University of Georgia announced that the Joro spider will spread up and down the East Coast over the next few years. It seems like these spiders are here to stay, but they aren't searching for homes to live in. They prefer to build their webs on the outside of a house or other structure. Joro spiders are venomous, but do not pose a danger to humans or pets, as they're typically reluctant to bite, and their bites and venom are very weak. Joro spiders will often only attempt to bite if they are being constrained. If this spider bites you or your pet, an allergic reaction is possible, but no instances have been reported. The Joro spider's lifespan is typically around 1 year, but can vary based on environmental conditions. An adult female spider can lay between 400 and 1,500 eggs in 1 year. They hatch in the spring, mature over the summer, and often die off by late fall or early winter in some cases, particularly in warmer climates. They may survive longer. A Joro spider's diet includes a variety of insects, such as mosquitoes, stink bugs, yellow jackets, beetles, bees, and biting flies. They are passive hunters and wait until a small insect gets tangled in their web. Once inside, the spider wraps the prey in silk and uses venom to subdue it. While Joro spiders aren't dangerous to humans, they can be a nuisance if you want to prevent these pests from settling in your yard or around the house. Consider these prevention tips. Watch your landscaping. Rich vegetation against your house could cause Joro spiders to settle there. Don't leave outdoor lights on. Bright lights can attract insects, which in turn can attract Joro spiders that will eat them. Eliminate hiding places. Joro spiders prefer lush vegetation, leaf piles, and wood piles. Clean your home regularly to check for spider webs and remove them. Seal cracks and holes around windows and doors to prevent spiders from entering. Implementing these strategies can help keep your home and yard free of Joro spiders, creating a more comfortable environment.